End of chapter 26. Chapter 27. An Afternoon at the Stone House.
"Where are you going all dressed up, Anne?" Davy wanted to know. "You look bully in that dress."
Anne had come down to dinner in a new dress of pale green muslin, the first color she had worn since Matthew's death. It became her perfectly, bringing out all the delicate, flower-like tints of her face and the gloss and burnish of her hair.
"Davy, how many times have I told you that you mustn't use that word?" she rebuked.
"I'm going to Echo Lodge."
"Take me with you," entreated Davy.
"I would if I were driving, but I'm going to walk, and it's too far for your eight-year-old legs. Besides, Paul is going with me, and I fear you won't enjoy yourself in his company."
"Oh, I like Paul lots better than I did," said Davy, beginning to make fearful inroads into his pudding. "Since I've got pretty good myself, I don't mind his being gooder so much. If I can keep on, I'll catch up with him some day, both in legs and goodness. Besides, Paul's real nice to us second primer boys in school. He won't let the other big boys meddle with us, and he shows us lots of games."
"How came Paul to fall into the brook at noon hour yesterday?" asked Anne. "I met him on the playground, such a dripping figure that I sent him promptly home for clothes without waiting to find out what had happened."
"Well, it was partly his accident," explained Davy. "He stuck his head in on purpose, but the rest of him fell in accidentally. We was all down at the brook, and Prilly Rogerson got mad at Paul about something. She's awful mean and horrid anyway, if she is pretty, and said that his grandmother put his hair up in curl rags every night. Paul wouldn't have minded what she said, I guess, but Gracie Andrews laughed, and Paul got awful red, 'cause Gracie's his girl, you know. He's clean gone on her, brings her flowers and carries her books as far as the shore road. He got as red as a beet and said his grandmother didn't do any such thing, and his hair was born curly, and then he laid down on the bank and stuck his head right into the spring to show them. Oh, it wasn't the spring we drink out of," seeing a horrified look on Marilla's face. "It was the little one lower down, but the bank's awful slippy, and Paul went right in. I tell you, he made a bully splash. Oh, Anne, Anne, I didn't mean to say that. It just slipped out before I thought. He made a splendid splash. But he looked so funny when he crawled out, all wet and muddy. The girls laughed more than ever, but Gracie didn't laugh. She looked sorry. Gracie's a nice girl, but she's got a snub nose. When I get big enough to have a girl, I won't have one with a snub nose. I'll pick one with a pretty nose like yours, Anne."